Hello everyone, and welcome to HowFixit. Today, we're opening up Apple's iPhone 17 Air to see what's new inside, how repair-friendly it is, and the safest way to get in without cracking anything. If you're curious about the rest of the lineup, check out our teardowns of the iPhone 17, iPhone 17 Pro, and iPhone 17 Pro Max, all linked below. For tools, I'm using a precision screwdriver set, plastic pry tools, tweezers, a suction cup, and a screen disassembly tool, essential for safely opening any iPhone. Links to everything are in the description below. Okay, let's begin. First, remove the two screws next to the USB-C port. Unlike the Pro models, the iPhone 17 Air opens from the back. Gently heat the perimeter for about 60 to 90 seconds at a temperature no higher than 90 degrees Celsius to soften the waterproof adhesive. Place a suction cup near the bottom edge to create a small gap, then slide in a plastic pick. Work your way around while keeping the back warm. Remember, there are two hinges at the top. When you reach them, push slightly downward to release. Once the adhesive lets go, lift the back cover like a book from the side. Watch for the connected flex cable and disconnect it before fully removing the panel. Opening the iPhone from the back is a big win for repairability. It's less risky than lifting out the screen. The 17 Air's rear cover contains the wireless charging coil, rear microphone, and LED flash, all connected by a single ribbon cable. Next, the battery. Apple continues to use electrically induced adhesive, first seen on the iPhone 16. To release it, you'll need a 9-volt battery and two small clamps. The iPhone 17 Air's battery has one insulating tab on each side. Peel these tabs back. This is where you'll connect power to activate the adhesive release. Connect the red wire to the positive terminal and the black wire to the negative terminal of the 9-volt battery. Now attach the red and black clips to the exposed battery tabs. Hold for about 3 minutes. If a clamp slips, reset it and repeat. Once the adhesive loosens, gently lift the battery straight out. Avoid prying with sharp tools. You don't want to puncture or deform the pack. The iPhone 17 Air battery is enclosed in a metal casing. This design improves cooling, boosts reliability, and provides better protection against accidental damage, essentially making the battery safer, more durable, and more repairable. The capacity is 3,149 mAh, rated for up to 27 hours of video playback. Up top, the Face ID assembly remains the familiar trio: front camera, dot projector, and infrared camera. No big surprises here. Apple's trusted layout continues. The earpiece speaker is a standard size for a phone this thin, not oversized, but adequate for calls and notifications. As for the camera, the iPhone 17 Air features a single 48-megapixel main sensor with dual fusion technology. It supports optical quality zoom, but unlike the Pro models, there's no dedicated ultra-wide or telephoto lens. At the heart of the Air is Apple's A19 Pro chip, a 6-core CPU with 2 performance cores and 4 efficiency cores, a 5-core GPU, and a 16-core neural engine. It delivers strong performance, though slightly less powerful than the Pro chips, which include an additional GPU core. All of this is packed into Apple's tight, stacked logic board design. Moving down, we find a relatively large Taptic Engine for a device this slim, delivering crisp haptic feedback without taking up much internal space. One welcome surprise is the modular charging port. The USB-C port is located on a separate ribbon cable, making replacement much easier, a design carried over from the iPhone 16 Pro. On the 17 Pro and Pro Max, the USB-C port is integrated with the bottom microphone, which complicates repairs. After removing another set of screws, we can lift out the two lower microphones. One is mounted on a long cable, which likely doubles as an antenna. All the openings on the bottom edge are for microphones. The single speaker is located at the top, serving both as the earpiece and the main audio output. This means the 17 Air doesn't deliver stereo sound, so headphones are the better option for media playback. Now, let's move to the display. As before, heat the perimeter to soften the adhesive. Apply a suction cup near the bottom, slide in a plastic pick, and work your way around. Removing the display on the 17 Air feels trickier than on the Pro models, likely because its slim design requires more adhesive. Still, with patience and the right tools, it's doable at home. Great news for DIY repairs. Remember, just like the back cover, the screen has two hinges at the top. Push slightly downward to release them. The iPhone 17 Air is equipped with a 6.5-inch Super Retina XDR OLED display. It reaches 3,000 nits outdoors, 1,600 nits for HDR, and 1,000 nits in typical brightness. And since most internal components are accessible through the back, you won't often need to remove the screen for repairs. At this point, we've completely disassembled the iPhone 17 Air and can draw some conclusions. Opening the iPhone 17 Air from the back instead of the front makes accessing internal components safer and more convenient, especially for routine repairs. The modular USB-C charging port is another welcome improvement, allowing for easier and cheaper replacements compared to the Pro models. The battery design is also a step forward. Its metal casing improves durability, cooling, and overall safety, while the electrically induced adhesive makes removal cleaner than older pull-tab systems. On the downside, the single top firing speaker limits the phone to mono sound, which feels like a compromise for such a modern device. Overall, the iPhone 17 Air is more repair-friendly than expected for such a thin model. If you'd like to see a more detailed disassembly and reassembly guide for the iPhone 17 Air, check out the video linked in the description below. Thanks for joining me on this teardown. If you found it helpful, don't forget to hit like and subscribe, and be sure to check out my other teardown videos. See you next time.